Sahodari brother and Mark is the middle one and my brother Frederick is the elder. We grew up in the north of India. Kumar and I were together in terrorism with our parents and I don't know for what reason, maybe we were handful, so they shipped off my eldest brother to Madras, to my grandparents' house, and he grew up in Madras. So Kumar and I grew up in Arul, and that's where I did my schooling. Now Kumar, with the eldest, always was there for me. He really looked after me, because I was more quiet. And you all know Mar, that he's very outward, outgoing, very boisterous. I'm very mild type of guy. So he was always there for me to protect me and to basically take care of me, make sure I was okay. And I guess I used to tag along more often than Mar. He was like quite good at public speaking. I'm pretty bad at public speaking. And so when you were a little older, Kumar started traveling lately and he did well. And then, so they expected me to take part in the games also, and it was quite a frightening thing for me to do, but I did it. And I remember one time when, like normally we used to have everything written down and memorized, and so that was okay. But then once I took part in a competition where we were given the topic just that day, and we had to come up with the whole thing and write it ourselves, and I was very terrified. And then Kumar actually came along and somehow he helped me through this whole process, so that overall I became full of myself and was made up quite well. And Kumar also, like when we were in Sunday school, he would be like taking part in all these plays that we had each year, and he would basically have the lead role. Like he was good at such things. And then finally he left for IIT, Kharagpur, that's where he studied. And so the final year of my school, I was the only one left, so I had to finally step up and do one of the plays myself. And I guess it went okay because everyone was happy. But it was just, I was basically following his footsteps in everything he did. Now Kumar went off to IIT Kharagpur, and then he got a job on the power scale. And that's where he spent a lot of his work career. And we heard a lot about his involvement in the church in the power. So once it was quite surprising when he said, "I have to preach in Hindi." And he did so well that he finally was preaching quite often there. And so he always was involved with the church. And in addition to that, he was involved in so many different things, always trying to help people. He was like always looking for how he can go out and help anyone in need. Anyone who came to him was always welcome and treated very well. And he would always look for ways to go out of his way to try and help anyone who came to the path. So he spent a lot of time in Bokaro. At that time, I immigrated to the US. So I was in the US and I used to get all the news from my mom. My mom was the one who was communicating everything. So she would get all the news and basically write to us, and she would hear about all the things that mom was doing in And then finally after we retired, we moved here to Bangalore, and this was his church. And I was fortunate enough a couple of years back to come here during Christmas and spend time with him with the kids. And we had a wonderful time. And he would just basically ask what you want to do. And he would take us around. It was quite a while since we had left, and everything was completely new here. He took us around. Arul was there with us. Basically, I saw how people were involved in the church here. And then even at home, people would come and visit, and how we correspond with the people, talk to people, get what their needs are, and what was a great help. I just heard that we started a Hindi congregation here, and a lot of people actually had their views also here, and he was telling me just today that he has started a Hindi congregation here, and he was very involved in that. So, overall, he spent his life basically as Christ for a person to do. And he has fought a good fight. He has kept the faith. It is very sad that he had to leave so soon. It was such a short time for him, and I got a message that he's no longer with us. And it is very curious to all of us that he's not there, not talking. We cannot share this laughter, how we used to bring the room alive every time we were there. But I know he's in heaven with Jesus. And so we are happy. We are happy to say that he has lived a good and faithful life. Now he's back with his Savior, with his Creator. And I'm thankful to God for that. I pray God for the blessing on Sutra, for Arul, Priya, Jeevitha, that you will surround them with your blessing, surround them with your peace. Pray God for your protection on them. Pray that you will be with them and be their guide as one of their guide. And take care of them. Thank you.